Thank you. In a previous life, I used to do a lot of VR work, and the guys at Pigs One are absolutely fantastic. So I don't know if you guys do open house, where did you go, but people should come and see that studio. Amazing, it'll blow your mind. So we ship on day one. We help teams ship software really, really, really quickly, quicker than they think is possible. I'm a little bit rusty on this presentation, mainly because of this guy. He's 4 weeks old. I don't sleep, neither does he. And two things are going to happen. I'm either going to go short or I'm going to go long. I've got no idea. I'm a little delirious. This might be a dream. I'm going to tell you the story of our company. It's called Ship on Day One. Like I say, we help other companies and other teams ship software on day one. Back in 2017, my co-founder, Eric, said, "Hey, Rob, have you noticed that some of these teams that we work with are really, really amazingly good at shipping software quickly?" And I said, that's really interesting. If you want to know what a startup in 2 years does to you, it's about 30 pounds difference between that and me right now. I said, yes, these teams are amazing. I run a couple of them. You run a couple of them. We have these software teams that for some reason just hum. They sing really well. They ship products quickly. Their product managers love working with them. Their teams love working with them. And we're not talking about small differences. At the time, Eric was running a Department of Defense project keeping tankers that refuel the Air Force's fighter jets in the sky. Raytheon had quoted about $1 billion to finish the project, and the team that Eric led completed the project with $100 million worth of budget. So massive orders of magnitude difference. At the time, I had two teams that were working on media. One of them was about seven times faster than the rest of the other teams that I was running and faster than their peers. So we're talking about these massive gaps in productivity between these engineering teams. So we set out to find out why. And we came up with an incredibly elaborate plan to do that that was very complex. One, find out why. Two, write that down. And three, help everyone that we met do the same thing. This was our idea. So with the help of some angel funding and no idea what we were doing, we decided that we would go and find out what makes some of these engineering teams high performing. And we interviewed about 100 different engineering teams. We met with CTOs, CEOs, principal engineers. We interrogated people. We sat there and bought coffee, bought drinks. We had lots of different meetings and whiteboard sessions and post-it notes and tried to get to the bottom of what is it that makes teams that perform really incredibly different. We found out at the beginning that everyone is smart. Everyone who is working on your product right now as a software engineer is doing a fantastic job. They are very smart, they're passionate, they love the product. Let's not talk about talent. It's got nothing to do with talent. Number two, it's not about intent. Every single team member on a software team wants to ship software really quickly and wants to ship it really, really well. There's no difference between a high-performing team and a low-performing team in terms of intent. And number three, I like post-it notes, lots and lots and lots of post-it notes. My wife got sick of finding post-it notes everywhere I went. What we actually found is that how a company supports its developers makes the difference. Now, this might seem like a really straightforward concept, but it's not. If you want your software engineering team to be high-performing, you have to invest in how you are supporting them. If you want a knowledge worker to be high-performing, you have to give them a desk, a phone, you have to give them a chair, you have to give them some method of getting in touch with people. If you want your software engineering team to be high-performing, you have to invest in the infrastructure and the capabilities around them. What we found is that there are 15 capabilities that set the teams that perform highly aside. You're right here, that monitor is terrible, but this one's not much better, and I will send the deck around to anyone who wants it. We found that there are 15 things that teams that are able to ship software at lightning speeds consistently invest in and provide their software engineers. And we wrote it down, and we called it Ship on Day One, and we said, great, let's figure out how we help people do it. We had no idea how we were going to do that. At first, we thought we were a software company. Then we thought we were a consulting company. Then we thought we were a software company. Then we thought we were a product company. Then we thought we were a training company. Then we thought we were a software product and training company. Now we're just a consulting company, and we're going to figure out everything else as we go along. So we run training boot camps. We help engineers, and we help engineering managers sell high-performing engineering teams to their company. There's a finger in the air. We have a benchmarking report that we work with companies on. We sit there and we come in. We say, hey, look, this is what high-performing engineering teams do. This is how far the gap is and how to close it. We're really good at it. For some reason, we've managed to land some really massive contracts. We just last week won a $6.9 million contract to help the United States Air Force ship software faster. That's pretty huge because we were going up with against companies like Raytheon and Aerospace and these huge government contractors, flew out to DC. That was kind of fun. And then we've also helped a number of different private companies do it. So we can help you too, but that's not what this is about today. Today I'm just going to tell you this is the thing. If you give your devs these things, if you invest intentionally in developing these capabilities, you will create happy developers, and happy developers will ship more software for your company, and your product will be a rock star. If you want to get in touch, here's my email address. I'll send you everything we have. We have white papers, we have data, we have research. If you want to sell your manager on the fact that you need an artifact management repository and you're fed up from the fact that it's on your credit card and not the company's credit card, we'll help you fix that problem. Get in touch. Q&A. I know that was 5 minutes because the bottle warmer for my baby is 5 minutes long. Yeah, it's like, okay, crying stops in 5 minutes off this warm bottle. Question?
I'd like to hear what your top 1, 2, 3 tips
that we give these companies. What are the top 1, 2, 3 tips that we give these companies? It's invest in the engineers. A lot of people think that you can give a software engineering team a laptop and maybe an AWS credentials and like that's it. And a lot of it is like, you need to think seriously about the difference between an engineering worker and a knowledge worker, and educate your IT department and educate your teams and your management about how to support them. It's support. Yes?
So how are you able to distill down the things that help software ship quickly? Is that from your experience or market research or what you guys do?
We spoke to about 100 different teams, 100 different CTOs, principal engineers. We collated everything that we looked at. We looked at source code. We went around for a while giving away free breakfast tacos for access to people's GitHub repositories. By the way, that was the most successful bribe. There's other bribes we tried. And we looked at everyone. We were just like consuming data and putting it in post-it notes and trying to collate it. We ended up with 250 things. And then decided to distill it down and bucket into 15. And we're like, these are the 15 things. If you invest in these 15 capabilities for your software engineering team, you will be doing nothing wrong. And you will be not preventing them from, you know, doing the wrong things. There are other factors that impact whether they're working on the right thing, but they will work well.
One more question.
Yes, man from somewhere else, right? Hawaii? Aloha. The government right now realizes that software engineering is a big issue, and that the government isn't very good at software engineering, and other companies, for example, China and Russia, don't care about bureaucracy, and they are investing in software engineering. So the United States government is spending a lot of time and effort right now trying to get better at software engineering as a core competency. And through nature of us being able to bid on some of the government contracts, we got them. I would say maybe 20% of our business is from government contracts, and the rest is from private companies.
All right, put your hands together again for Sodo.